Sridhar Ramakrishna. He is the past president of Medling, past area governor, founder and mentor of orators of Tech Mahindra, HCL Speech Weavers and Chennai Articulators Club. And regarding the theme, what he said was, many a times we talk about successful startups, but there are many failed startups too. People should not quit regular jobs and aim for startups thinking that the grass on the other side would be green. So,
General Evaluator, Toastmasters and guests. The recent times I saw a news item in Europe. Now they are strictly, they are going to enforce anti-plagiarism software from school days onwards. Even students, children who are using their assignments, even at 6th standard level, people are supposed to validate their writing with the help of an anti-plagiarism software. And only when it is proved, then only it will be accepted. So today, that is the power of IP and the plagiarism. So today, Toastmaster Sunil attempted to give a speech which is relevant to all of us, including the small kid. Right? Today, every one of us should be aware how we are trying to violate IP, especially in countries like India. We take it for granted, and that is the time, this is the high time we bring such kind of awareness. So today, let me try to highlight what are the other strengths of the speaker. One is the relevance of the topic. Number two is the title of the speech. CN Circle. Until the speaker comes on stage and try to make his opening comments, till that time we were all clueless and we were eager to listen to your speech. So that way you created some kind of curiosity by having an appropriate and distinct title. That was awesome. The third strength of the speaker was his delivery approach. He tried to use 5 whys and 1 aspect. What are they? Who, when, what, where, why. So he talked about what is IP and where to apply it, who can apply it, when to apply it, and finally how to apply it. So all those things with the simple language, simple words, and the simple slides, he made all of us understand the concept. It was a tough concept, and primarily the objective is to take a technical subject and try to elaborate in front of a non-technical audience who are no way connected. And he did a wonderful job, and kudos to him. Give him a big round of applause. So what he could have done in a better manner is, one is, almost at the fag end of his speech, he came out with a lot of visuals. That was awesome. Probably if I were in your position, I could have used those slides, especially that movie slide on Sarkar. Probably that can be your first slide, and you can ask a question. So any guess what I'm going to talk about today? Probably you could have interacted with the audience and then started building on your presentation. Then second thing is connect with the Toastmasters. Definitely Toastmasters, they are also concerned about IP and plagiarism. Every contest we are talking about how people are being disqualified due to plagiarism. Only 20% of your content can be borrowed content. If it is more than that, then you are disqualified on plagiarism. So you could have narrated an incident how the speaker, though his content was awesome, because 30%, 40% was plagiarism content, he was disqualified, then it would have reached the message to the entire audience. The third thing is, in this project you are also supposed to do Q&A session. So due to lack of your planning and preparation, you somehow skipped it. So probably since the next project also involves PPT and its usage, you can incorporate these suggestions. Otherwise, it was a simple message conveyed to the non-technical audience. You did partially succeed. Over to General Evaluator.